You know, you may have heard this story. It was about a police officer. His name was Ryan Holetz, who's the father of four from Albuquerque. And while he was out on patrol, September of 2017, Officer Ryan came across a woman by the name of Crystal Champ and her companion, Tom. Well, when he found them, they were shooting up heroin behind a convenience store. Crystal was 8.5 months pregnant. And so, obviously concerned with the well-being of the unborn baby, Officer Ryan tried to reason with Crystal. He said, you're going to kill your baby, he said. But the more they talked, the stronger Ryan felt God telling him to adopt Crystal's baby. He just felt God saying, tell her that you'll do it, because you can. And you know, 3 weeks later, Ryan and his wife became parents for the fifth time when Crystal gave birth to a beautiful baby girl that they very fittingly named Hope. Amazing story, right? But it doesn't end there. Rather than sending Crystal and Tom to jail for their drug use, Officer Ryan used his own resources to help these two very severe drug addicts get clean. And so over the next several months, both Crystal and Tom underwent a 90-day rehab program in which Tom graduated and Crystal later graduated. They're getting back on their feet. And Ryan and his family, I mean, when you hear a story like that, they are the very essence of what the Bible calls love thy neighbor. Love thy neighbor, right? It's so interesting, that verse, you know, love your neighbors yourself, it's found 8 times in the Bible, right? Not once, not twice, 8 times. So loving your neighbors yourself is so important to God. He not only repeats himself, but he made it a command. And if you remember, Jesus coupled this command to love your neighbors yourself with loving God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, all your strength. James, remember, in the book of James calls it the royal law. Love thy neighbor, right? It seems such a basic commandment, very straightforward. But as I think all of us know, loving our neighbor is not always easy, which is probably why God made it a command, because he knew we were going to struggle with this one. So why a commandment to love thy neighbor? God knew loving our neighbor is something we have to do on purpose. In other words, we have to be very intentional about it, or it's just not going to happen. And I say all of that because so many right now, as we know, are struggling right now, going through very difficult hardships. But actually, that should cause us to grab hands with one another, to pull us closer together, not apart from each other. So this Sunday at the Vineyard, we're going to look at what it means to love thy neighbor. And when we start obeying that command to do that, to love our neighbor, we're going to see, I believe, God shine like a beacon of light in our city of Santa Fe and beyond, New Mexico, across the world, actually. So set your clocks back an hour. This is daylight savings. And then we're going to see you on Sunday. Can hardly wait.